want to know one thing. Are you with me or not?
Afterwards. You're a monkey, Superman. Father Robertson, Scotland Yard.
Constable Collins. Constable Frank, sir.
A white line. Yes. Now, in France, going that way, they would drive on this side of the road.
Don't worry about me, Andrea. As soon as I've offloaded the smack, I'm going to retire. It's only the stupid ones that pedal again. They're the ones that get caught.
You know the meaning of the term Queen's evidence?
You mean like a supercross?
In Angleterre, Monsieur Dennis, we still drive on the...
left.
Left! The left! Correct! Driving on this side of the road when you should have been driving on this side of the road.
When is this boat coming?
Look, I know this sounds unconvincing. It's all been a big mistake! You're a man.
An evil force took his life. An unearthly power has brought him back. He is a phantom. A wraith. A cosmic spirit given another chance.
Are you new in town?
Yeah.
Who's the kid?
I turned my back and the next second he was there. Like magic almost.
You ever seen one of those before?
Nah, let's just add it to our collection.
There's a kid out there using his car to kill people. Not that it's such a big deal, since it seems to be your gang he's got it in for.
Hold on! Grab the shotgun, Mama Luca.
A wraith, man! A ghost! An evil spirit, and it ain't cool!
What are you doing? Packard, stop!
Get in the car.
What are you doing, man? You
get out of my face, Burger Boy. You wind up dead like your brother.
No! Hey, who is that guy?
I don't know. But whoever he was, he's weird and ticked off.
I see his eyes, Loomis!
Who are you?
The Wraith. If you've done nothing wrong, you've got nothing to fear.
Thank you.
there are places where nothing ever seems to change. But here, nothing is what it seems. He saw it.
Something came out of the sky. A meteor or something.
No one believed it.
Don't be talking about things you don't know nothing about.
Tastes funny.
It makes vegetables taste weird.
There's nothing wrong with the water.
It's making you sick. Can't you see that?
Now, there's no way to stop the curse. It has come from the heavens, but what it has brought is hell. Will Wheaton of Stand By Me must stand alone against The Curse. A film by David Keith from a story by H.P. Lovecraft.
Say, be careful with that. That's it. Breakable.
Let's hit it, kid. The meter's running.
It's all right, Mother.
You promise you'll write?
I'll write, Mom.
Call if you need anything.
Except money.
I promise I'll call.
You be careful at that college, son. Don't let them turn you into a communist.
They'll never take me alive, Dad.
First time away from home.
Whatever gave you that idea?
Come on, Mother. Let's go home and get you drunk.
For ourselves, every precious second.
call.
I don't know.
Down the stairs, to the left, go over the three doors.
Excuse me, could you tell me how to get to Hayes Hall?
With a line like that, you can't be serious.
Oh, there was, I didn't... Are you having engine trouble?
Not anymore.
Oh, good.
Want a ride?
No, thanks. It's a nice day. I'll just walk. Where's room 66?
The men's section. Follow him. It's a pentagram. It wards off evil spirits and creeps.
Does it work?
Well, we'll know as soon as you leave.
Oh, yeah. Right. Oh!
Great.
I'm sorry.
That's great. Nice move. Oh.
Hi, I'm your roommate.
I knew you'd be happy to see me, but I wasn't expecting this.
Dean!
So how was your summer without me?
Get lost, will you?
Whatever you say. You know, I think you're being a bit hasty, Harry. An opportunity like this doesn't come along every day. I think we should seize it.
Yeah.
Gladys, good to see you.
Fuck off, Dean.
But you're my roommate.
I bet this is my side of the room.
All right, Dean Roberts.
Hi, I'm Andy Cooper.
Oh, I hope you don't mind. Better stereo separation.
Well, actually, this,
You're flexible. I like that in a roommate. 100 watts per side. Digital programming. This baby will melt your brains.
Terrific. Just listen to those strings.
Yeah. That's nice.
Oh, that's enough of that crap.
music.
All right!
Killed for less.
Listen, we're gonna have to lay down a few rules here, okay?
I'm glad you brought that up. Rule number one. This means do not disturb. Now, you remember the signal. We sing a lot of it.
Now, what's that supposed to mean?
It means that I'm rich, handsome, charming, and girls worship the ground at my feet. So, I suggest you make alternate sleeping arrangements for most of your stay here.
If you think that I'm gonna let you lock me out of my own room, you're absolutely crazy.
Hi, Dean. Do you want to look at my portfolio now?
Oh, but of course. Step into my office. Hey, Andy, great to meet you guys. See you around, okay?
You can't.
Gladys. Oh, sorry. I can't believe it. My roommate decides to throw a party. Ow. On the first night back. Oh. It's you.
I'm Andy Cooper.
Carrie Hansen.
Oh, I was just, doodling.
You're in fine arts?
Mm-hmm. I'm in Nicole Hubert's studio.
Oh, yeah. Me too.
Thank you.
So you're Dean's roommate.
How did you know that?
Well, everyone knows Dean. He's a legend.
Huh.
His last roommate preferred that couch. It's more comfortable.
Thank you.
Steve, I can't take these from you. You already paid me.
You earned them.
What did I tell you?
This must have been one of Marcel's last major works.
Whatever. Dynamite, buddy. Just dynamite.
Andre Marcel. Wow.
With a teacher like that, now you know why I'm in fine arts.
There she is. Who? Carrie. Come on.
It's a long time to wait.
It's worth it.
What is that?
He is so cool.
Good morning, ladies. I'd like you to meet my new roommate. Andy something or other.
Cooper.
Oh, you two know each other?
Yeah. We slept together.
Fuchsia is a lovely color, I think.
Can I give you a hand here?
Let me give you a hand on that.
No, no. I got it. See?
You started without me. And how did this happen?
Oh, it was gravity mostly, but I helped.
No matter. This is not a classroom. What happens here is your concern, not mine. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Nicole Hubert. There will be no books. No lectures, no exams. What we stress here is creativity. You may do anything you like.
Anything?
Within reason. I only ask that you don't destroy the studio. You are already artists. I want you to look to me as a guide, not as a teacher. Agreed? We shall be friends.
Yeah, who is this? Hi, I'm Andy Cooper.
Droid.
Floyd?
Droid.
Is that your real name, Droid?
Names aren't real.
Who's that guy?
He's not sure.
Hey, watch it, asshole!
I like that in a man.
Say, hi.
Hello.
Thanks for sticking up for me earlier.
Yeah, well, it was partly my fault.
There's a Cuba show down at the Sign Gallery on Thursday night. I thought
she's busy.
No longer lost, I see. You are?
I'm Andy Cooper now.
Andy, I've seen your portfolio. It's very good.
Thank you.
Well, I look forward to seeing more of your work.
Well, where do you see some of my work?
I've already seen you at work. Excuse me.
But it's home.
This is how it's done. This is how it's done. Everybody needs a friend who will be there.
Smell it?
What?
Hormones, millions of them, all over the place.
What is your course? What you do? So
my boy, I just spotted my bed warmer for the night.
Say, there's Carrie.
I got dibs.
Screw you.
Does that make you a competitor?
I hope so. Competition's fun. Except when you lose.
I don't lose. Just follow my lead, Eddie. This is a master at work.
Good evening, ladies.
I must say, you're looking lovely.
Join you?
Why, thanks. Don't mind if we do.
I tell you, there's a couple of strings missing off her racket.
So we meet again. What did you say your name was?
Helen Dobish.
Helen Dobish. Helen Dobish. That is a lovely name.
I hate it.
Me too. Stinks up the place.
I'm glad you made it.
So am I.
You know that you are the most ravishing creature on the face of the earth?
Yes.
This is for you.
It's beautiful.
Well, I had a good subject to work with.
You know, I'd rip the shirt off my back for a dance with you. And then we could work on your shirt.
What have I got to lose?
We'll discuss that later. Virginity is an ugly thing.
I mean, if you look at history, it's obvious that men have been responsible for everything bad. Have you ever stopped to think that nam, spelled backwards, is man?
Wow. That is heavy.
Thanks.
So sweet of you.
I'm glad you like it.
Do you remember when I said I'd never leave you?
Gene, are you all right? Campus life. Don't you just love it? Hey, Helen, wait up!
What's so funny?
I was just thinking about Dean. He's really quite a character.
Let's not talk about Dean.
When did you first start to paint?
When I was a kid. My dad bought me some felt tip markers for my 10th birthday. And I drew cartoons all over the living room wall. Next day, he bought me some paints and an easel.
Well, at least he understood.
That was the last time I was ever spanked.
How did your mom take all this?
She died when I was 7.
That's a shame. Well, at least you turned out all right. Would it spoil a friendship if I were to kiss you? Taking this a little bit too fast.
Huh?
I just want to be the first one to say it.
I do have to go, though. I have an early class.
Oh, sure.
Honest. Bye.
Bye.
Dean, don't!
Dean! What the hell are you doing?
Go away!
Dean, please come in.
No, you're right, I'm scuffed.
Dean, don't do it!
Get out of the way, Andy, or I'll land on you.
Dean, I'm sorry. I didn't mean all those things.
I don't believe you. I can't be hurt again.
Oh, it's all right. I won't hurt you. Come inside.
Oh, Andy.
I hope you were taking notes.
It's a piece of shit.
Shh!
It's a piece of shit.
It is not.
Well, look at it. It looks like a piece of shit.
Keep your voice down.
All right, so what's it called?
A piece of shit.
Lunch was lovely as usual.
My pleasure. Perhaps you're free Saturday night.
Perhaps not.
Pity.
Excuse me. Monsieur Cooper? I would like to introduce to you a very dear friend of mine, Mr. Robert Blay. Mm-hmm. And I believe he has an announcement to make.
Mm. Oh, yes. As you may know, my annual showing of works by local artists begins next month. Nicole has persuaded me to open the show to her students, and I very graciously agreed.
Unfortunately, Mr. Blake can choose only one of your works for the show. Naturally, if it's sold, the proceeds will go to the artist.
Minus my 50% commission, of course.
I wasn't that persuasive.
Lesson number one. Art is a business.
Any questions?
Yeah. How much is that thing?
$15,000.
Not bad for a piece of shit. So childish.
Aren't you, like, going to do something?
No. I'm going to do nothing. Reality is just a pale imitation of perfection. Only by reaching a state of nothingness can we create art.
Wow. That is deep. That is so deep. Really, believe me, I know deep. May I see?
I was going to do a sculpture, but I'm stuck. I mean, I don't know what medium to use. I really wanted to try something different.
Why don't you come to my office after class? Maybe I can help, André Marcel used to take hundreds of photographs looking for inspiration. Within them, he would see a shape, a form, a composition. From there, he would feel what to do. And you don't think art. You see, and you feel. This is where art lives,
Thank you.
You know, I think we need a widescreen TV. These portables just don't cut it.
Where do you get all your money?
My folks are well off.
Yeah, well, what do they do?
They have some businesses.
Like what?
Distilleries at first. And then they moved into pharmaceuticals, trucking, concrete, the entertainment industry.
Laundry business? Sounds like the mob.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Hey, you should put that camera to good use.
Yeah, I'm going to.
Right on. Hey, you show me the shots of Carrie, and I will give you the VCR.
What are you talking about?
Oh, come on, come on. I've seen the cow eyes that you two make at each other.
Well, there's nothing going on.
Oh, a little kissy face, pressy belly.
There's more to life than sex, Dean.
Yeah, damn shame, isn't it?
Nothing. Have you seen these here before?
Uh-uh. Still stuck for an idea?
Well, no, but I could use some inspiration.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Thank you.
A very provocative style, lots of anger and energy.
Thanks.
But your backhand needs work.
It's very 70s, wouldn't you say?
I don't remember the 70s.
Pertinent child.
Stuffy old fart.
Quite a balanced composition, wouldn't you say?
Oh, very nice. Passionate yet pure. A very striking balance. Is it titled?
I'm calling it Ambition.
Robert, it's very nice. I like it. Very fitting.
Carrie, wait. Forget about Blay. Look at the junk that he had on display at his gallery.
What if I just don't have it?
Hey, Carrie. I think that you paint beautifully.
Prejudiced.
Yeah, you bet I am.
Good.
Hey, Andy, come on, open up.
Up our complexions, I see.
Can't we have a little privacy around here?
Sorry, I gotta get some things together for tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, it'll be great to have some peace and quiet for a change.
We're gonna be taking off around 9. Is that okay with you? I'm giving you a ride home. It's on my way.
I forgot to tell you. Well, I guess I better pack. See you later, okay?
It's on your way, huh?
Hey, I'm just trying to help out.
It starts to sink.
I guess you better go.
Guess so.
Thinking of you when they bring up the Thanksgiving turkey.
Who's there?
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Oh, you're not interrupting. I was just bored.
Aren't you going home for Thanksgiving?
No. Home's pretty far away.
I know the feeling. It's going to be beautiful. Andy, you have a remarkable talent.
Well, I had help.
You know, I'm famished. Have you eaten?
Well, no.
Would you like to have dinner with me?
Please?
I hate to eat alone.
All right.
Here, let me give you a hand.
Like the restaurant I chose?
Oh, yeah. You know, all we had where I grew up was a hunk of beef. Say, tell me, what were those things that you ordered, the round dish and all the sauce?
Escargot. Snails.
Snails? I ate snails?
You know, it's pretty warm in here. I don't really think we're going to need a fire.
Whatever you like. Would you pour me a cognac?
Yeah, sure.
Comfortable.
Well, yeah, I'm very comfortable. If I were any more comfortable, I'd be uncomfortable. Is that the original?
Mm-hmm. It was a gift from Aunt Way.
Oh, that's beautiful.
The painting? Or the subject?
Or the painting, of course.
I think I know what you mean.
You loved him a lot, didn't you?
You are very much like him.
I'm like André Marcel.
It's true.
With it, make it quick.
can hold on. Roll with it, make it quick. I can't hold on. A world unto its own, hiding away, not even fantasy. And you, harder than steam, faster than light, warmer than make-believe. And I don't wanna fight anymore. Don't push me to pull me. And there's no better way of finding out the score.
Aren't you going a little fast?
You don't like my driving?
No.
At least you don't look bored anymore.
Look out for this car.
Magnificent.
No, I hope Blade thinks so.
You know he will.
Put him down, Guido. Guido, this is Andy. You're not to hurt him unless he touches my stereo.
Tom. Likewise.
Excuse me. Strong like bull, smart like streetcar. God, my life is over.
Where did you get that animal?
I inherited him.
From who?
Where'd you spend the weekend? In bed?
Or so?
My Uncle Lou.
Your uncle was in the mob.
Well, remember when you asked about the family business?
Are we talking about the mob?
Well, Andy, there's only one. And my family has the trademark. And now my dad wants me to take over my uncle's end of the business.
You mean like drugs and prostitution?
No, worse. My Uncle Lou was in charge of investment banking. Oh, Andy, what am I gonna do? I don't fit in with these people. How would you like to go through life being known as Don Dean and kissing other men?
I see what you mean.
forgot to tell you the best part. Guido's gonna be staying with us.
Do you snore?
No.
Too bad. Guido snores like a horse. Don't you, Guido?
That's what all girls say.
Carrie! Oh, have you seen Andy?
No. Guess what?
What?
Droid and I are moving in together.
Congratulations!
Thanks. He's found us a terrific loft off campus.
We can use it as a studio. It's right next to a meatpacking plant.
That's nice. Guess who?
Carrie.
Well, of course. Who else? I knew I'd find you hiding.
Hiding?
Here.
No, I'm not hiding here.
It's wonderful. Andy, it's just wonderful. You must have been busy this weekend.
Not really, no.
I thought about you a lot.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Guess what?
What?
I missed you. Miss Hubert.
Hi.
I'm sorry.
Did you have a nice weekend?
Oh, yes. Lovely, thank you. Lovely. Excuse me. Do you love her?
Yes.
Then she mustn't ever know.
We should stop.
I know. I can't.
I saw you with on campus.
Oh, Mr. Friend.
A good friend?
An old friend. We went to school in Paris years ago. Satisfied?
Okay.
Hey!
fucking up, Andy.
What?
I said you're fucking up. As in blowing it, fumbling the ball, flushing down the toilet.
A gift. I thought he said
oh, we're close. Get out of here.
What do you mean?
Carrie's been feeling very neglected lately.
That's none of your business.
The hell it isn't. She's wearing three good shirts crying on my shoulder. We all know what that could lead to.
She's been crying.
Buckets. So, who is she, Andy?
Who?
Your little side piece. Oh, please. You're talking to an expert. I know the symptoms.
That is definitely none of your business. Okay, okay. Just so long as you realize that makes Carrie fair game now.
Stay away from her.
You remember your cousin Frank?
Uh-huh.
He's dead now. He used to say that women were like the ocean and that guys are like rocks. And the waves of the ocean smooth out the rocks and they break them down into little pebbles. And then the little pebbles get married.
You stay away from Carrie.
To a shining new artist and his sculpture.
Thank you. To Desire.
Oh, Desire now, is it? Well, it's good anyway. Selling your first piece is very impressive. Pan Global Petroleum will present the check at the opening.
Yeah, I still can't believe it.
Yes. They rape the land, they gouge us at the gas pumps, and absolve their conscience by supporting the arts. Oh, and lining our pockets in the process. Oh, there's Nicole. I haven't told her about the sale yet. Nicole, I just informed your protege here.
Can I help you?
Faster!
The last thing that I wanted to do was hurt you.
Right. You didn't want to hurt me.
It's the truth.
What a joke. First you say you love me, then you go and knock up the art teacher.
It was like I was addicted or something.
Bullshit! You didn't care about me. All you wanted to do was to get your fucking sculpture in that gallery.
That's not true.
I never want to see you again.
Uh.
let it all... Oh. Yes, I know. He's a dirty rat. He really shouldn't have done those things to you.
What did you find out?
Does it matter? Why didn't you tell me?
I didn't think that you could deal with it.
Oh, but I can. Nicole, there are so many things that I wanted to say to you that I didn't think I was going to be able to remember them all, so I wrote them down. It's a little smudged. Dear Nicole, I admit that it was a shock when I heard about this event. No, please, this is a really good part. It's coming up now. But after thinking about it, I finally realized that we have been truly blessed. I thought you'd like that part. And I would consider it a great honor if you would marry me.
I don't know what to say.
Oh, I remember that part. You just say yes and I say...
No, Andy.
No.
No.
I could write another. Why? Is it my age?
Andy, you are trying to do the decent thing, even though it's wrong for you.
I don't understand.
I wanted a baby, Andy. I don't want to get married.
Wait. You planned this?
Don't.
You mean I thought we had something special and now I find out that I was just convenient? Well, what's the going stud rate, Nicole? $7,000 in a gallery show? That's the seal of approval.
Andy. I'm sorry.
Thank you.
taking the plane.
Hi. Can't go in there.
What?
Miss Carrie's in there with Mr. Dean.
Well, that bastard, let me in there, Guido. I've got to talk to
you. I got my orders.
Guido.
What?
If I asked you nicely, will you shoot me?
Sure.
Forget it. With my luck, I'd probably live.
Though you've read that women have little sensation beyond the opening and the outer third of the vagina, you're extremely turned on when your man thrusts deeply. Is your case unusual? A, yes. B, no.
I need to talk to you.
That's not Miss Carrie. That's Nate. Get out of here.
Andre Marcel. You fucked me over.
Yeah, but Andre Marcel did not screw around.
Since when do you know so much about art?
I'm an artist.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Well, do you have any of your stuff here? Well, can I see some of it?
Well, if you promise that you wouldn't laugh.
Guido, I wouldn't laugh at you if you wore ballet tights. Excellent technique.
Well, I was trying to capture the color and the passion of the subject.
And the velvet enhances that.
You think so? I was concerned about that, but I think it works well.
It's very good.
Oh, I'm so glad that you like it. Thank you.
Guido.
What?
Artist to artist. Won't you please tell me where Carrie is?
No. And you want to know why? Yeah. Because I don't think that you love her.
Oh, you're nuts.
Andy, look. You and me are serious artists, right? Right?
Right.
Then how could you possibly care more about Carrie than you do about your work? Tell me that.
All right, then. I'm gonna have to beat it out of you.
What are you talking? Andy, you're gonna hurt yourself.
I'm warning you.
What are you doing?
I'm not kidding.
You're crazed with love.
Tell me where she is.
My Aunt Blanche, she told me once, what goes around comes around. So if you go around with two girls, one of them is gonna come around eventually and clobber you in the nuts.
Oh, God, I really messed things up.
The way I see it, life is a matter of making choices and sticking to them. Take me. My mother wanted me to be a bookie, but I was a stubborn kid. I wanted to be a hitman.
Now, what if you make the wrong choice?
There ain't no second chances. That's the deal. Make your choice and stick to it.
A note of congratulations to Pan Global Petroleum, the purchasers of the work.
It looks like a forest with a mirror coming out of it. It's beautiful.
Well, it should be, Guido. It sure cost me enough.
Now it is my pleasure to introduce the artist, Andy Cooper.
This is really a terrific opportunity. It's probably more than I deserve. A friend of mine told me that life is making choices and sticking to them. That's him over there. As a matter of fact, he did this. Oh, it's all right, I deserved it.
Yeah.
There's a story about Robert Rauschenberg and William de Kooning. Apparently, Rauschenberg went to de Kooning one day and asked him if he could erase one of his drawings and then display it as a de Kooning erased by Rauschenberg.
Well, de Kooning thought about this for a little while, and then he decided that he could, but only if he chose the sketch himself. When de Kooning took Rauschenberg the drawing, the only thing that he said to him was, "It's my favorite." And then Rauschenberg erased it. I guess that with things worthwhile, you've got to give up value to get value. My friend says that there are no second chances, but I think that he's wrong.
Andy, what are you doing?
Andy, no!
My commission! I don't know about you, but I feel a lot better. You can keep this. Decent thing to do. I really hope that I'll get a chance to meet him someday.
Now will you take me to see Carrie?
Well, my mother told me never to argue with a crazy person. And man, you are seriously crazy.
She's here?
Yeah, if we're not too late.
Hey man, hey, you smashed the car! Where is she?
Guido, help!
Not this time, Mr. Dean.
What did you do with her, you bastard? Relax, she's gone.
Where?
Gone. Went home, dropped out.
You and her, you weren't...
No, your friend. I wouldn't do that to a friend. Besides, she turned me down. There's no accounting for taste.
Where is she?
She's probably on the ferry by now. She's catching the 6 o'clock plane home at the airport.
That's across town, but I think there's still time. Guido, can you drive me to the ferry?
Let's go.
Wait! Maybe I can help.
Thanks.
What are we for?
So, what are you going to say to her when you get there?
It's me.
My cousin Tony. You remember Tony, Mr. Dean, don't you?
Yeah, right.
He's dead now. He tried to win this girl back, right? So he cut off his little finger and he mailed it to her with a card.
Well, did it work?
No, she flushed it down the toilet. Women, go figure them, huh? We got trouble.
Damn! Andy, wait, we can drive around again.
Very happy for you, lad, but couldn't you have waited until we docked?
Carrie, Carrie, wait! Like this.
You really hurt me. Andy, I can't just forget what happened.
I know. But can you forgive me?
Yourself?
Yes.
Good.
Maybe we could try to start again. Carrie?
I love you.
What do you know? There are second chances.
What?
Oh, it's a long story, Mr. Dean. It's a long story. Come on, we'll get you some chicken wings or souvlaki or something.
Can I ride in the front with you?
Sure. You got it.
Be my friend, can you forgive me? I won't forget what I've done. Yesterday's pain will be just a memory, 'cause I know you are the one. To try starting over, I know it won't be easy. The hurting just can't be undone. But this time's forever. I've learned my lesson, 'cause I know you are the one. Oh,
what do you know?
There are second chances.
Making it right
is a start.
Finding true love
in 80s romances is easy if it's from the heart, from the heart. Tomorrow is ours, the feeling just gets stronger. Future together's begun. Value for value, I now know the meaning, and I know you are the one.
Oh, what do you know?
There are second chances.
Making it right
is a start.
Finding true love
in 80s romances is easy if it's from the heart, from the heart. I know that it's so easy if it's from the heart.
Was the perfect setup to infiltrate a drug operation from the inside. But suddenly, something went terribly wrong.
We sent 20 of our best agents down there to bust up that little paradise. 7 of them are missing in action. They mailed the rest of them to us in very small pieces.
I'll send you a postcard.
How are you going to handle it?
Like I always do. Organized chaos.
She's his only hope for survival and the last stand for justice.
She's coming and you can't stop her.
She's afraid of me. I'm not afraid of her.
If you're dealing with the underworld, the game can get dirty.
This place has got to burn.
But when you call in this dynamic duo, the game will change and the war will just begin. Because they're the army that's going to blow this battle wide open. Cobra's Brian Towson. And Playmate of the Year, Kathy Showers. Together, they're the toughest team in town, rewriting the book on law and order. Sometimes it's not how you play the game, it's how you win. And if you want to win, call in Commando Squad.
You figure I'll turn this dumb bastard on, and while he's huffing and puffing, you'll grab the gun, right?
Where do you think you're going? Freeze!
April Fool.
Is she one of you?
This team is the government's secret weapon.
Federal agents do not kick people in the head.
You're under arrest.
Freeze!
In the war on crime. They're following a trail of intrigue and murder over the hills of San Francisco to the underworld of Argentina.
You got right to work.
A hot trail to a cold-blooded killer.
You got anything on him?
Jesus, the body's washed up. I told you to anchor it, didn't I?
What do we got here?
They mutilated her breasts.
To hit him where it hurts, she's got to live in the line of fire, under suspicion.
You ain't bugging me again!
And under the gun. Feel the Heat, from Sterling Sullivan, Academy Award-winning writer of The Poseidon Adventure, and In the Heat of the Night, David Dukes, Tiana Alexandra, Rod Steiger.
Who the hell are all these guys in the white hats?
Definitely not on our side.
No.
He makes being a cop an adventure. She makes it an art with a twist. When they're on fire, stand back and feel the heat.